This tutorial is part of our practical database design course. You can find a link to the YouTube playlist for this course in the video description. Alternatively, if you like this course, you can watch the complete course uninterrupted, ad-free, access updated tutorials and download the source code and more from our Udemy course. Again, the link to the course is in the video description. In this tutorial, we introduce the term database, what it means, and the purpose of a database, all in the context of the most popular database type, relational databases. It is difficult for us to discuss relational databases without also introducing the relational database management system. Therefore, in this tutorial, we will also introduce and learn the basics or the basic purpose of relational database management systems. I will make a promise that this course will not induce you with anything. So then finally, I want to plant a seed. Having a more holistic view, so a more wider view of the design process, being proactive and thinking ahead is an important skill. Therefore, in this tutorial, I will touch upon the importance of the data lifecycle and how it might affect our thinking in the database design process. Something that I feel books and materials don't impress upon enough is that building a database isn't just about following a set of standards in a static way. It is a dynamic process. We need to think long-term. Thinking about our data in a process helps us to better design databases. Although in this course, we are focusing in on the what I just described as the most popular type of database, relational databases, let's just acknowledge that there are many different types of databases, each providing different methods for structuring information. So we're going to be discussing throughout this course relational databases, but you may also read through object-oriented databases or hierarchical databases or indeed network databases. If you have just started learning about databases or you're currently on a course, a database course, you are most likely learning about relational databases. It is a well-established approach which has been used for well over 30 years. The relational database. Let's think about this as an approach. It is an approach or a way of storing or structuring information in tables, rows, and columns. The term relational in relational databases stems from the concept that a relational database provides the ability to link or build relationships between information held in different tables. In this course, we will learn how to organize tables, normalize tables, and fields, and then establish relationships between tables. Even with that small amount of information, maybe we can now better answer the question, what is a database? I like to think about a database as an organized collection of data. In a database, we find data or information. So choosing the type of database will characterize how the data is organized, stored, and accessed. I do like to visualize concepts where possible. So let's think of a database as a container for storing a collection of data. Designing a relational database, we determine how to organize or structure our data in this database container effectively. Generally, the better organized something is, the easier it can be to find or work with. We might say the same about our database. The better we design our database, the easier it might be to work with the data in the database, and more importantly, how effective it is at protecting the integrity of our data. Now, don't worry if you don't know what data integrity is. I will mention data integrity more often than you will ever need to hear in this course, such is the importance of it. I will briefly mention it here in this slide, and then we can discuss details later in the course. Data integrity refers to the accuracy, the completeness, and the consistency of our data stored in the database. As database developers, architects, we aim to ensure that we design our database to give the best possible chance that we can always maintain data integrity throughout the lifecycle of the data. So, even at this early stage, in my opinion, I think it's best for us to think about our data moving through a process over time. By doing that, when creating a database design, we are always thinking ahead and not in a static way. So this diagram is adapted from a traditional view of a data lifecycle for the purpose of focusing on considerations when designing our database in this course. As we work through the design process, we tend to think about our data moving through these typical stages of our data lifecycle. So take the first stage of this data lifecycle, creation. This is when data gets created, either by human input or potentially by a computer. How this might affect my development or design process, I might ask myself when designing a database questions such as, do I have all the tables I need to create the data the database needs to store? So now that I might have all my data successfully stored, I'm now asking myself the questions such as, can I actually use the data? So let's remember that the person creating the database design might not be the person who will build or maintain or work with the database. So I'm asking myself the question when designing, can others easily understand the design? The naming, for example, that I've used. Can the developer actually return or retrieve data they need to work with from the database? So making the assumption we now have a database design which will support the data and make it easy for others to work with the database, I'm now thinking about modification. Will the database design support or allow data to be changed correctly? Or will it cause errors in the data should someone make some modifications on the data? So far, we have discussed the idea that data can be created. It needs to be usable by others, and potentially that data will get modified at some point in the lifecycle of that data. Now, last of all, data might be deleted or it might get deleted. So when designing my database, I'm thinking of questions such as, can I safely delete data without affecting the integrity of other data in my database? Or if I delete data, will it delete all the data correctly? So hopefully that's given you a snapshot, if you like, of the fact that data is dynamic. It changes, it gets modified, it gets accessed by multiple users and other systems potentially, and eventually it may or may not be deleted. So these are just some of the questions and considerations when designing a database. Okay, so going back to our database, when we initially introduced the key concepts of a relational database, we stated that a database is made up of tables and fields. I won't introduce fields, that will be discussed in an individual tutorial, but let's bring in the idea of tables. I've stated that database contains information, but in actual fact, in a database, we have tables. And inside of our table, that's where the data or information is stored. So tables contain the information about a particular entity, a subject, or a related thing we need to store data about. If we think of a database as a container, it is a container which will contain or store our tables. As you can see from the diagram, a database may consist of one or more tables. Through the database design process in this course, we will learn how to establish, organize, and connect our tables in the database. Knowing what tables to actually build is a skill and will be determined upon multiple factors, such as the data that we need to save in the database, or quite possibly the functional requirements of the software that the database is being designed for. That is important to remember if it wasn't clear already. A database normally doesn't operate on its own. Typically, it provides a service for other applications to interact with the information held within the database. So now we have our database, we've built some tables, now what? So this is where the relational database management system comes into play, which is essentially software which will allow us to actually construct our design in a way so that we can actually start to store data. In the world of relational databases, there are many different database management system software, popular being MySQL and Postgres databases. In addition to that, you also find many, many more: Oracle, Microsoft SQL Server, or potentially a lighter version, SQLite. There are many different database management software systems, and there are many other ways you can actually pronounce the names of them. So some will call SQL SQL, some may not, for example. So how you actually pronounce it doesn't necessarily matter, but just be aware that others will pronounce these names slightly differently. So if we bring the relational database management system into our diagram, you can see here that it wraps around the database. And then inside of our database, we have tables. So although we depict a single database, it is important to know that the relational database management system can manage multiple databases. To briefly summarize some of the information in this tutorial, we learned that the database was an organized collection of data. In this course, we're going to be discussing relational databases. The characteristics of a relational database include tables, rows, and fields. Although in this tutorial, we didn't mention or reference rows and fields, we will discuss that in later tutorials. And then finally, once we have developed our design, we need some way of actually realizing our database, and we use a relational database management software system in order for us to actually build our database and manage our database moving forward.